Hi, this is Pat Johnson, your psychology instructor, and in this mini lecture, we're going to continue our discussion of operant conditioning and talk about the concepts of extinction and shaping. We've already talked about extinction before. If you remember, we talked about extinction in classical conditioning, and extinction just means to make a behavior go away. In classical conditioning, we can make an involuntary behavior go away by extinguishing it because, remember, in classical conditioning, we're only dealing with involuntary responses, responses you have no control over. In operant conditioning, we can extinguish a voluntary behavior. In other words, we can make a behavior that people choose to do go away. In operant conditioning, this is done very easily. All we need to do to extinguish a voluntary behavior is by removing the reinforcer. Now, let's suppose our student raises their hand and the teacher gives them a piece of candy. And this primary reinforcer makes the child raise their hand more and more. And let's suppose the teacher gave the child candy each time the child raised his or her hand, and then all of a sudden the teacher ran out of candy and there was no more candy. Now the child might raise their hand a few times, but when they realize that the hand raising did not lead to any more candy, our child stops raising their hand. We've extinguished the behavior because we removed the reinforcer. No more candy, no more hand raising. Now, I love teaching. Teaching is a main part of my life. I love interacting with students. But if they remove the reinforcer for teaching, in my case, a paycheck, I would probably stop teaching because I need to live, so I need to have a job that pays. All right, let's talk about the concept of shaping now. Shaping is an operant conditioning procedure in which reinforcers guide action closer and closer towards the desired behavior. This is a definition from your textbook, but let's add a few things. When we're talking about shaping, we're talking about teaching complex voluntary behaviors. So if I want to teach a child to play baseball because I hope they get a baseball scholarship to pay for college, I don't start out my little kid with a 100-mile-an-hour fastball thrown at them. A kid would probably get scared. They wouldn't be able to hit it. What I would use is shaping. And again, shaping, we're going to reinforce closer and closer toward the desired behavior. Another textbook says successive approximations to the target behavior. In other words, baby steps towards what you want that subject to do. So in this case, the father is helping the little kid and showing him how to hold the bat, and they're going to start out with t-ball, and maybe even the father will help the kid hit the t-ball the first few times. And then maybe there's an intermittent step here where the kid is hitting the t-ball on their own. And then we try a slow-pitched softball where it's underhanded and the ball is going fairly slowly, and the kid practices that way. And then we move finally to baseball where it's a faster pitch overhand and then maybe faster and faster. But what we're doing is those baby steps, those reinforcing those intermittent steps closer and closer towards the target behavior.